Hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here. We're back for some more Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. In this part, we'll be exploring floors 4 and 5, because in the last one, in floor 3, we pretty much did everything we can in the boiler room, and we got our first Jiggy in the packing room, so awesome. Definitely making some progress in this world. At least I hope so. And right here, we see in the boilers, two chimneys. I guess you wouldn't tell from in here, but these are the two chimneys we saw outside of Grunty Industries. And, in one of them is a little entranceway, and in order to, get to this Jinjo, we have to pull some Santa-like escapades to reach it. So, maybe by the end of this part, we'll be seeing, rescuing that Jinjo, because, we'll be unlocking something that'll make our travels on the outside much easier, and, we can go from outside from within, like we did with the train. And, without further ado, let's actually, get this empty honeycomb that I couldn't get with the, clockwork egg in the last part. And we'll set our plan in motion, and my plan for this part is to show off floors 4 and 5, like I said before. We're gonna show off some more things outside the factory that we couldn't access before, and we'll be unlocking something that'll help us do that. And, I think Mumbo will actually make a cameo by the middle of this part, and he'll be unlocking something, and, yeah, a lot of things to do, and probably learning a new move, and I can't believe I actually made that jump right there. I failed at that countless times in my practice run. And over there is a Jinjo. I actually know better, and that is a fake Jinjo, so I'm just gonna kill you. There you go. Oh my... This is... Oh my god, that was violent. Oh my god, I blew it up and it got brain damage on the way back down. Oh man, this is Sparta, Jinjo. But yeah, this is the fire exit over here that we want to exit out of. Because that will take us to floor 4, because I don't think I can get to floor 4 without going this way. And we don't have a warp head up here yet, so this is the only way to do so. The only feasible way. So here we go, floor 4. Yeah, and down here, if you want to go back outside, there's actually spring step shoes, so definitely worth noting. We want to avoid these deadly garbage pails of acid. But yeah, to get over here, this is the quality control, I think it said. Yeah, quality control. It can only be accessed by mechanical personnel only, so, Wumbo will definitely help us in that department. Obviously, this is a, mechanical-like transformation in this world that will help us out a ton. And over here is actually what I want to access that will make our outside travels much easier. We get some fly pads, awesome, so we can definitely reach the top of the chimneys because one of them obviously leads to a Jinjo, and there's definitely other things we can access on the top of the roof and to the sides of the windows that we can break through. So, awesome. I don't know, the level design in this world is really, really good. I really have been crapping all over this world, and I've been seeing the comments. I've been liking how you guys have commented, yes, this world's not that good, but it has great level design. And I respect a lot of people actually like this world, and a lot of people don't, but yeah, I can see both sides, and it's been nice seeing everyone commenting about how this world is either really good, really bad, and whatnot, so definitely keep it up in the comments section. But right here we have a Mumbo Pad, and as you can see in front of us, we can't get to the other side with that thing crunching down, so we have to just go to Mumbo, enlist his help, because like I said before, he is the EMP of this world, that is his spell, and he will disable that thing just enough time for us to squeeze on through, so we're gonna get Mumbo's help right here. He's got a couple of more pads that he can help us with, but for now we're just gonna get him for this single job right here because it leads to a Jiggy that I'm not gonna go after. I just wanted to show off the area and just make it so he can access it at any time, but I'm not gonna lie, I practiced this part. Because when I usually record, I practice the part I'm going to be doing before I actually do the part. So I couldn't for the life of me get this Jiggy. It's just an incredibly hard one. It's one of those first-person sections like we saw with the TNT thing and with the Mayhem Temple. But this one is just, this one takes the cake. This one is, I thought the dynamite one was hard and, whoops, okay, it'll give me a little more time to explain this. But I thought the dynamite one was hard. This one is incredibly hard. There's definitely a twist to it, I guess you would say, but yeah, I'm definitely not looking forward to that. Mumbo, take it away, EMP, wall crushers. Oh man, so I'm definitely, I don't know, a part of me wants to at least show it off, but I know I'm not gonna complete it because on two separate occasions, I had one left. You can take out 20 of them. I had one left, and oh man, I can't handle that kind of failure again. And Bell Crusher malfunction. Initialize auto fixing program. Crusher will now be reactivated in 45 seconds. Oh wow, that's a lot of annoying noise right here. But luckily, I'll probably turn down the audio on the video on this. Because I've been adjusting some audio features in my videos and my commentary as well. I've been doing things in Audacity, so hopefully it sounds much better. And having a new computer definitely certainly helped. So, ready for that. But right now, we only have 45 seconds to switch. Oh, okay. Mumbo, don't be doing that now. We're on time limit, so you have 28 more seconds to come back and switch back to Banjo and Kazooie. And it should be enough time, but still, I'm kind of dawdling right here. I'm usually faster than this, but let's go back to Banjo-Kazooie Floor 3, and luckily when we go on, like, warp pads, the time stops, so. Yeah, and the belt is going forward right now, so that's definitely making us go faster right here, so that certainly helps. And let's just go on the Banjo-Kazooie pad, and now this will be open for now on, and Mumbo's magic doesn't matter anymore. So yeah, we open up that area, and over here, we got some empty honeycombs we can get, or honeycomb pieces, sorry, to restore our life, but we didn't take that much damage, or damage at all. And so yeah, this is basically to get to that jiggy I was talking about. We'll climb up here because there's an elevator shaft, and I'll be using it, so not total loss here, and here is the elevator shaft. Let's just open that up, but I'm just gonna keep going up and showing off that area. But yeah, I'm not gonna try to do it now. I'll try to do it later because it'll be a waste of time if I try to do it now, and I'm not really feeling confident after the walloping I took after the hour of practicing it. And yeah, I don't know. It takes a special kind of run to be able to do it too as well. I have the map on my game guide, but it's just, that does not help at all, and I don't want to deal with it right now, but no, it's one of those first-person sections where you have to use Kazooie as a gun, and it's probably my least favorite kind of sections in this game, so yeah, I'm going to take a pass. I'm going to take a rain check on that one, and right here we have the elevator shaft. Remember the move that, the cheat that I should say, we got before entering this world? Probably the best use for it, because watch, we're just gonna go over here. You can't get to floor 5 through the elevator shaft, unfortunately, only floors 1 through 4. And unscrew bolts with the bill drill, we already know that, but this one, the twin chimneys both have a prize. One was the Jinjo, I'm curious what the other one might be. Maybe it's a Jiggy, but look at this! Oh my god! Banjo, I'm so sorry. Oh! Oh, where are you at? Oh man, okay. Normally, Banjo would have gotten no fall damage there, and it would have been very gruesome, but wow, okay, if I didn't have that cheat on, that would have been clutch, but yeah, I kind of wanted to see Banjo get flattened right there, but unfortunately, no, I saved him at the last second, unfortunately. Why am I saying unfortunately? I saved his life. Banjo, you owe me one, but yeah, how do I get over there? I want to get those two notes. I didn't see those before. I'm going to use the clockwork egg to get over there. So it has... Oh, come on, really? Ugh. Yick. What did I want to do? I wanted to open up that with the batteries. That are a battery, I should say, by going over here. And there was actually one above the entrance of the world that we entered. So I have to actually swap out right here. I'm kind of bummed I didn't have enough clockwork eggs. I guess I've been abusing them by doing some sequence breaking of my own. So I guess that's the penalty and the price I pay for that. But yeah, we're going to leave with just Banjo only outside. And get the battery that is above the entranceway. And we're gonna actually do some manipulating, doing some more Banjo double jumping. I really don't know if this was intentional or not, but I'm gonna definitely take it either way. And let's just go up here. And then really the rain kind of adds the crappiness of this world. Like, come on, really? Eesh. Let's just get him in the corner and smack him. There we go. He's all dizzy and confused, dazed and confused. Put him in the backpack, and there we go. And let's actually go to that area that I showed before. And if you saw up there, there's actually a 20 note thing. Oh god, that thing's gaining on me. Ugh! It almost hit me with that wrench, but I evaded the last second. So we'll be getting that once we use our fly pad. Probably toward the end of the part, I think that was my plan. But the plan right now is to activate or to open up the waste disposal plant because move for Banjo lies there. As well as a Jiggy, but we can't get to that Jiggy just yet, so. Yeah, let's just go up here, ignore the glowing thing of doom and wisdom, and there we go. Let's just take out the battery, activate power here, and there we go. Waste disposal plant is now open. Additional battery power channel 2 door. Access is now granted. Oh, right, super. So we'll be going in here, and we'll be learning a new move, and Jam Jar's luckily, right here for us, and we have enough notes, 115, I think, more. And there we go, the snooze pack. When you're feeling rather low, I know a place that you can go. LT or RT, followed by right stick, removes your pack. Have a nap to get energy back. And there we go, heals us up, and that'll be all. Dismissed. Oh, jam jars, I don't know, I'm such a masochist, I guess you'd say. I just enjoy other people's suffering and pain, but that is certainly funny. I just cannot get enough of that. So yeah, basically the new move we learned is you hold down LT and hit right on the stick. There we go, we can sleep, and normally if I didn't have any health, that would restore it. So I'll just show it off right here. Oops, I took damage, but let's just get some cover and snooze. And we heal up, so awesome. Definitely useful for a lot of jiggies in this game. And one right here we can actually get with the snooze pack, so that's definitely why I just got it now. So yeah, right, our quota right now is a jiggy apart, but that's 10 parts, so we definitely have to keep up the pace, but... Okay, ooh, floor 1 trash compactor, intruder in the trash compactor, clean up droids, report to floor 1. Okay, a lot of smashing right here. Yeah, the gold feathers don't really do anything here, so it's up to your snooze pack, so... Let's just, get enough distance. We'll take the damage right here. But luckily, there's a midway point right here we can actually use the snooze pack and heal right back up. And this would have definitely came in handy with the, I think this does come in handy. We have to go back to Pterodactyl Land and avoid those... the foot monster kind of guy, and we can sleep in his footprints and get something that way. So I think it was like a Jiggy or Jinjo or something like that, so we have to go back to do that. And we have activated that switch, and there we go, we got a Jiggy waiting for us, and let's just heal up again. So yeah, there we go, another Jiggy, so that's two Jiggies that we can get, I think out of a possible 7, because 3 we cannot get without learning certain moves, so that's definitely exciting. So only 5 more to go, okay. Not so bad, not so bad, and where is that Jiggy? Okay, Banjo's head, sorry about that. Of course it's on the other side, I should have realized that. Hey man, I didn't really know that Banjo's backpack was even that big. Like, looking on his back, I don't know, man. You could fit a whole bear in there, wow! Okay. His backpack, I don't know, up until this point, doesn't have any superpowers. It's not like a freaking, like, magic bag or anything, but Kazooie's been living in it, so maybe it is like a giant world inside there. Who knows, and, I hear a cry. Let's see if we can talk to this guy, maybe. There we go, it's a rabbit. Oh, look at the state of my overalls. I'll be in real trouble if I can't find a way of getting them clean. Yeah, that's where our transformation friend comes into effect. And now my... I need Kazoo. I need Kazoo to get the thing. Don't know why I'm saying things in the rares of 3. But, yeah, let's get Kazooie back. But like I was saying, the transformation will be useful in that capacity of, cleaning their overalls. So, it's a mechanical machine, and it cleans things. I know, it must be! This transformation. Okay, I don't want to spoil it, I don't know. I like to keep things fresh and, keep you guys guessing. I don't know, a lot of people may be watching this for the first time, but I highly doubt that. A lot of people that usually watch my videos are fans of the video games that I play, so... Chances are they've seen it already, and, yeah. Okay, buddy. Okay, I don't want to jump around right now. Okay, come on. Grenade! And... Okay, there's... Okay, good. Got him, I think. Oh, come on, there's more! I just need to break open this. Come on. There we go, got it. Alright, good. And here we go, there's an old friend, Lago! Hey there, Banjo. Lago, what are you doing here? Well, Grunty ripped me out of her mansion and stuck me in here. Boy, you should see the mess some of those workers make. I don't want to know. Anyway, someone thought it was funny to fill me with paper. I really need unblocking, if you wouldn't mind. We do, actually. Well, Kazooie, you have no choice in the matter. Let's just drill him out and use our plunger attack. Did that help? Yep, I can feel him moving in my... You, Ben, you better stand back. This could be messy. And yay, we get a Cheeto page for helping out Lago. It's a Cheeto book page. No use to me, though. I only lack the quilted stuff. I guess you can have it. So there we go. We got a Cheeto page by doing that. And I don't know why I'm giving people southern voices in this part. I don't know. I'm just going to roll with it, I guess. And I don't think we can access that middle room. I'll check, though. But there's another one of the rabbits in here. I think there's 7 of them, too. So got a lot of overalls to clean. So I think we're done in here. So let's just leave. I don't feel like getting zapped anymore. And of course, we can't break into the woman's room. Because that would be naughty. That's a bet. That's definitely something Conker maybe would do in another Rare game, but not Banjo-Kazooie. This is a quote-unquote kids' game with all subliminal messages still. So yes, now the plan is to actually go outside and do some flying around with Banjo and Kazooie. And then I think that will be a part because I'm just looking over now. 15 minutes. Wow, this part really flew by, didn't it? Didn't really do a lot of accomplishing, but we got to floor 4. I said I'd be getting to floor 5, so maybe we'll be doing more of that. I really want to explore floor 5 by the end of this part, so. And luckily, right next to the fly pad, we have a window right here we can break through. And there we go, we smash it. Sorry again, Kazooie, you're really getting, you're being used as a plot. Oh, really song. You're getting used as a plunger, we're using you to break glass with your face. Ugh. Terrible job you have, don't you? Then again, I'm sure Banjo gives you a lot of attention and care and birdseed. And yeah, there's a Cheeto page in there, so two Cheeto pages in the last, like, minute or so. Cool. And luckily, another fly pad, and I think this time we'll be making our way up. Just keep hitting that A button. Actually, I want to check if there's any more windows we can break outside first before we go all the way up, so let me just do a roundabout, I guess you would say, around and see if there's any breakable windows. But as you can see right here, that's where we were before, to get to the fire exit, I guess you would say, to get to more floors. And let's just do a first-person view. Another fly pad's right there. That's a Minjo. So ignore that. A lot of Minjos in this world, and there's actually a Jinjo we can get up there by doing some teamwork with Banjo and Kazooie. So I'll probably be doing that probably in the next part, maybe? I'm not sure. And, ooh, another window. Let's break that open. And let's just get back into this mode and get inside there and see what this goes to. Oh, hey, we got some unscrew, or screws to unscrew, I guess you'd say. So screw you. Whoa, okay, nice. This will break down that. Okay, that was the last rabbit that I didn't help. Okay, my practice went awesome. Okay, so we had to do it this way. I didn't know that. Awesome. Okay, I was trying all different ways to try to get over there as the transformation, but nothing helped. But there we go. We got a pathway now. Awesome. And now that's broken up, and I think we're done with this area. Okay, that was the second floor. And now we're going to go across in here and get that. Okay, we'll actually get this treble clef right here. Might as well right here. And let's just do that. Get our 20 notes. There we go. And we just had to make our way back over there to get the fly pad again. And I missed that completely. Okay. Oh, wow. We only have 2 health left. Crap. I didn't even notice. Did not notice at all because death is not a consequence in this game, so I really don't pay attention to my health at any time at all. And let's just keep flying up. It's good to know that we have 200 feathers to help us out. And let's just go up here. There we go. And there is actually a warp pad, so awesome. I don't know why there's workers up here on the rooftop. Nothing really to unclog your wrench or unscrew your wrenches up here. So don't know what purpose you kind of serve. And, oh, okay, I got a spring pad. Let's just go up here, because I believe there is a window we can break open. That'll take us to floor 6. So this, I don't know, this world definitely reminds me of Rusty Bucket Bay a lot, especially with this part. That, I don't know, they definitely took this straight up from Rusty Bucket Bay. This is looking very, very similar. And this is a storage area at floor 5. I just want to make sure there's no security. Gotta be a Solid Snake Banjo. Okay, there is security. Now, where's the camera? Gotta look for that camera. But luckily, if we're on the boxes and not on the floor, it doesn't activate, so... I don't know. I don't see it. Oh, I may have to take a chance right here. Then again, I'm low on health. Crap. You know what? We'll take a chance. I'm surprised. I guess he is authorized personnel, so he wouldn't matter. But, yeah, we'll get this Jinjo. That's actually a real Jinjo. And, yeah, we can access that area through the washing machine. I think this is the quality control area? I'm not sure. I think that's... No, it can't be. Cannot be at all. And let's just go across this, this little thing right here. And anything else we can do in floor 3? Because, I don't know, to get to the other side of floor 5, we have to get the... We have to get the transformation! I kind of spilled out what we were getting, so... Did some editing. Let's see here. Yeah, unfortunately, we're done with this area for now, so we got a Jinjo at least. That's something. And I think we'll finish out the part by getting another Jinjo, the one I was talking about in the beginning, in the boiler room. But to do that, we have to go on top of the chimneys, so... Is there a fly pad up here? I hope there is. So yeah, again, not a lot of progress in this part, but hey, we had to do it. In the first two parts, like I said, they're more of unlocking things, so definitely knew this was coming. And let's see, is there anything on the chimneys? Nothing on that one. There's an empty honeycomb on that. We definitely want that. So there's the second secret. So they didn't totally copy Rusty Bucket Bay and make it a jiggy, so. And yeah, we have 10 empty honeycombs. We can definitely get an extra life if we want. Maybe I'll do that off screen, not sure. But I think we should be fine in terms of health, though. So we should be good. Let's just get some distance right here by doing a beak bomb thing and circle back around. And let's see, there's supposed to be an area we can open up on the chimney. And of course, it's on the other side. And let's just go like that. Circle back around. And okay, we have a thing right here. Oh, I only have one grenade, so we gotta make this count. There we go, got it. And let's just fly down into the opening in the chimney. And there we go, we're back in the boiler room. So we just went full circle right here. We began the part in the boiler room, and we ended the part in the boiler room. And there's actually anything else I can get up here while I'm here? I don't think so. So yes, I think we'll end it here. Deja vu. And in the next part of Let's Play Banjo-Tooie, we'll be pretty much going back to Floor 1 and making our way back up and seeing what we can actually do now in the factory, that now that everything is pretty much unlocked. I really don't know what I want to do. Do I want to do the transformation stuff first? Or I want to explore the rest of the factory as Banjo-Kazooie? Or not explore the rest, but start doing some things with them now we have unlocked everything. So without further ado, I will end this part. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time on Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. This really is deja vu.